Good morning, Alan Bragwell here. Just wanted to reach out a little bit in between some sessions today. I've got a pretty busy Christmas Eve work day, but that doesn't surprise me because that's kind of the way it's been since COVID started and the way things are going. But I wanted to take a few minutes and just post a video about some things that I've been sharing with people. I thought, you know, maybe these would be some ideas that could be some help to some folks if you're in some of the tight places that we're going through right now with COVID being restricted travel, isolation, perhaps not being able to go and do, and so much of our regular routines have been upset. But it's just sort of the general topic of how can we celebrate Christmas in a difficult time. You know, when I look back in the scriptures, it was a difficult time the very first Christmas. Mary and Joseph going, you know, up to Jerusalem from where they were at, living and going up that direction and ending up in Bethlehem. And it's a hilly, if you've never been there, it's a rough, hilly area. It's not unlike, as I've posted on Facebook before, it's like going, I can't imagine walking from Greenville, South Carolina up to Asheville, but that's the change in elevation from like 500 feet above sea level to over 2,000 up around where Bethlehem is outside of Jerusalem. It's quite a climb to, on a, you know, making that trip. It just, I can't imagine. That's a tough thing that they were going through. And we're going through some tough times right now as well. But it's also the opportunity for us to push through and to focus on things that really, really matter. So what are some things that they did in that first Christmas that we can do today? One of them is to just tell others, that we can tell others about what's going on in our life, that even though there's tough things, there's some things we're blessed with and positive about. I know back in the days before social media and before the technology that we have now, a lot of times just a basic phone call. I've been encouraging folks to make a basic list of people that they could call and just check in with and just wish just happy Christmas, as they say in England, or Merry Christmas here, and just reach out to some folks that maybe you haven't talked to in a while. It's not hard to do, and it can be a good thing. Another thing that happened in that first Christmas is they were pretty much amazed by the whole thing. And I think what happens, you know, when you think about Mary, Joseph, shepherds, angels, innkeepers that ain't got no room and are trying to help them out but doesn't have anything to offer them but a stable, a cave basically is what it was more likely in Bethlehem, that it's an amazing story. Well, we've had some amazing stories this year too that where Christ has been in our midst or situations have occurred. So I want to encourage you to, if you make those phone calls, if you do reach out to tell others, is enjoy and tell and share your stories. Share the stories because the stories are the things that last. And what do we do if we were able to, and maybe you're going to be able to have a traditional gathering of some sort for tonight or tomorrow or this weekend, is what do we end up doing? We're sharing stories about family, things that have happened in the past. Those things change. It gets our mind off of the stuff that we're doing, and it gets our minds on other positive things. You know, it also says in the Luke's account of the first Christmas that Mary pondered things. She thought about them, and of course, that's an ongoing process that she did. That's something that we can do when you're not in a group, when you're not sitting, you know, around with people, if you have the opportunity to do that, but if you're just by yourself, is be in the moment and enjoy the moment for what it is and what it offers. I think everybody remembers the Christmas Story movie that's set in the 1940, just before World War II in Ohio. And the kid wanting the BB gun. But there's the last scene of the movie is, I think, is really special, and it kind of connects with me in the idea of pondering or thinking about what's going on. And that is this snowing, and the day's over, and the kids are in bed, and he's got his BB gun, and his brother's got that toy Zeppelin. Mom and Dad are just sitting on the chair in the living room looking out at his snowing, and the Christmas tree's in the window. That's what we can do ourselves. I mean, get a cup of coffee or a cocoa or something and just sit down by your tree. If it warms up enough, which it won't today, if it did, you could enjoy a moment outside. But find a place, a time for you just to rest and chill and enjoy the moment. And finally, the thing that's sort of obvious in the first Christmas was the praise and worship that occurred. The angels, the shepherds went back to their area not far from where the baby Jesus was, and they were thankful, and they enjoyed a time of worship and praise. Find an online service tonight. Maybe if the church that you attend or you're familiar with is offering one, do that. Just be in the moment with them and try to find a service that might be online where you could enjoy, even though you might not be able to get to a service. That's one of our traditions. It's been, even though we didn't attend First Methodist in Russellville over the years, we would walk down the hill and go down there to the annual Christmas Eve service because the church we attended didn't have one. And we made it a part of our life. And so tonight our plan is that we won't be able to go to a regular service, but we're going to do an online, join one online and participate that way. And if you don't want to do that, have one in your living room or in your den or by the fireplace or in the by the tree or something. Do something that will give you an opportunity personally and in your family to have a time of praise and worship. One of the memories that I have is, and I've written about this and talked about this before, was 5 years ago tonight, I spent Christmas Eve by myself at Emory University Hospital after having open heart surgery. I'd never been through anything like it before in my life, but I'll never forget it because I had a sense of gratitude and appreciation for being alive, number one. Number two, for those nurses and those nurse practitioners that came in all night on Christmas Eve and were checking on me and giving me shots, giving me my meds and stuff. But also just the overwhelming sense of God's presence with me in that hospital room in Atlanta on Christmas Eve. Well, thankfully, you won't be in a hospital room tonight. You may have a family member that is, but be assured that Christ is with us. He's never, his promise was and is that he will never leave us and forsake us. So again, thanks for letting me just share a few minutes in between my appointment times with my clients. God bless you. And as my friends in England say, Happy Christmas.